I feel like, because I've played with you a bunch of times and I know you as a player, find whatever mechanism you can to peel away that chasing of somebody else's validation.
Yeah.
And deliver the music that you wrote or that your group wrote because you think it's just important to deliver, not because it needs something in return. That's where people get hung up. People say, do it for the love, right? Maybe that's what that's about, right? Delivering it without any expectation of return and then see what you get back.
Yeah.
You know, if you give it and you're expecting something, you know, I mean, you've already screwed yourself, I think, well, to be honest.
Yeah.
Like, you can be you. Like, you can be Billy. You can be Anton. I saw you being Billy. That's why I brought this whole solo thing up, because you were you, man. It was completely you. You 100%. Were moving. Your hips were moving. You were feeling good. You were being straight up Billy, unapologetically.
That's what my girlfriend says all the time. Do I look happy when I'm on stage? She's like, you look like the happiest person ever to exist when I play music. Yeah, that's how I am when I play. Because I love it so much. Maybe you just love it too much. Maybe that's your problem.
Well, no, that is the problem. The problem is that, like,
The validation thing, like Ben's saying, I think that's it.
The validation, the validation thing comes from me attaching my entire identity to my ability to play music,
which is silly because look at you. You're a friend.
Don't make it weird, though, right?
It's 50.
You know, no, but
best
you're
friend.
Right? You're a friend. You're a...
Reptilian, confirmed.
You're a reptilian. You're a reptilian.
Oh, I'm a brother. I'm a son.
You're a brother. You're a companion. You're a lover. All these different things to these different people. Your identity isn't... That was like when, you know, Herd of Watts wrapped up. You know, I had to deal with a major sense of identity because I had put a lot of that stock in that same place. You know, I've never been more free as a musician, and I've learned a lot since then, both about myself and music and playing and working to improve and all these kinds of things, but didn't come until, you know, some of what I'm kind of encouraging you to ask, because those are things I ask myself. It's not like I'm sitting here saying, hey, you need to do this for yourself.
No,
all I'm saying is those are questions that until Tony was challenging me to like accept where I am, it was more than I think just like where I am as a player. Accept where you are if you want to grow and then grow. And that turned into learning how to give without expecting anything back. And it's not because it's not important to me, because it is important to me that I want to give it without expecting anything back. That's a serious paradigm shift. And I think it will free you a lot. And it will make you feel like, hey, when I go out there and I'm Anton, that's good enough. Because you know what? No matter what, that's all you're going to be able to give anyway.
Yeah.
Right? You're not going to be able to give something that you don't have. And so if you get comfortable giving who you are and what you have, I think it'll make a huge difference. And that's made a huge difference, like in our group. And there's also trust. When you can be Anton and Billy's being Billy, then nobody's worried about being anything.
Never worried.
No one's worried about being anything.
Just go on stage, flip the whole audience off just to start and be like...
just to start, yeah.
I'm just saying. And then just be like, fuck
you.
Because
now you're starting
I'm gonna
at
play
a deficit.
Guitar.
So
no,
like,
you're going to be like, I don't care about you right now. This isn't about you. This is about me.
Yeah.
And then flip them all off.
Well, now we're taking it to a whole different...
Smoke
a
cigarette on
stage.
Security's like, no, you can't fucking smoke on here. Be like, no. You stay down there.
Yeah.
And then just rip it. See what happens.
What,
Lord. I'm not condoning that set of advice, but like I said, I know kind of where you're at, right? And the kind of things you focus on and work on and what your influences are. The only thing that I think keeps you locked up is yourself, right?
Yeah.
And that's easy to talk about here, like on the couch. But look, I mean, hopefully that kind of thought process, like if you can find whatever piece, maybe you take a part of that and you make it unique to you and you kind of change that advice and make whatever it's going to make sense to you, it may pay off in the other things that you were talking about at the beginning. Some of the way that you work through the challenges of carrying the weight of the administrative pieces of the band,
right?
Maybe it pays off in some of these other things that, because all those things, if, hey, you feel like, hey, this stuff needs to happen, all of that is also pulling away at your ability to focus on being the best Anton that you can be.
100%.
And so maybe you can find a middle ground. It's not that stuff's going to go away. Maybe your dynamic doesn't allow for that, which is totally fine, right? That's a whole different like band conversation, right? Sometimes you got to be fine with that. That's totally fine as well. But that makes it even more important that you find a framework or like a thought process that allows you to not worry about the things you're worried about when it's time to play music. Because I know what you're capable of, man. I've seen you in all kind of different settings, all kind of different shows and all that sort of stuff. You know, the mental game is difficult until you don't care about the mental game.
Yeah.
You know, like, to hell with that game, man. Like, what the fuck? It ain't doing you any favors.
Yeah,
it's
no,
not
it's
doing
definitely
you any
not.
Favors. Self-doubt is a nasty monster, and I don't have it all locked down. I at least feel like, for me personally, I know how to think about it now. It's like kids afraid of the dark till you learn where the light switch is. And it doesn't mean that still doesn't freak you out a little bit, but you know where the light switch is. Find your light switch, man.
I'm just thinking about making t-shirts that just say, be the best Anton you can be.
There you go, man. And then now everyone's going to wear the... I would wear it every time and just embarrass the shit out of you when I come to play. We'll be like, yeah, be the best Anton.
If it gets fucking...
I want to be the best Anton I can be.
I want to be the best Anton I can be, too. Like, so bad.
Oh, my God, dude, that's awesome.
If it gets people in the door, bro, I'm for it.